Now, one thing, another trick, this is moving to a different concept, that you want to take a look at and make sure you see on the exam is the pronouns they, their, and them. Okay? These are used to trick you because we use these incorrectly all the time in our everyday speech. And you may not see how these are used grammatically incorrect on the test. So whenever you see the pronouns they, their, or them, be sure to slow down and locate your subject and make sure they match the subject. And I'm going to talk to you about that in a second, okay? Now, let's take a look at what that might look like on the praxis handout or the praxis exam. Again, we're going to choose the part of the sentence that is incorrect. If there's nothing that's incorrect and there's no error, we're going to choose E. So we have, when the university went through its academic programs, they saw students who were never on campus were more likely to drop out during their second term than those who were on campus all the time. All right, so I've got some pronouns here. I have its right here, they and their, and I'm going to slow down with these they and theirs because I know they're probably trying to trip me up here. So let's take a look at its first. Let's take a look at A. When the university went through its academic programs, its is the pronoun, okay? And it's talking about university. This is the pronoun, its. The university is what we call the antecedent or the thing the pronoun is talking about, all right? In this case, this is pronoun antecedent agreement. The university is one thing. I know that people all the time would say, when the university went through their academic programs, they would assign their to university because there are 50,000 people on the who are part of the university, but it doesn't matter. The university is what we call a collective noun, and it is one thing. So if we want pronoun antecedent agreement, we would say that its is the proper pronoun to use here because the university is one thing, so I'm not going to choose A. And then we have this, they saw students. Who is the pronoun they talking about? Well, it's talking about the university. So this is pronoun antecedent disagreement because I just told you that the university is one thing. They indicates more than one thing. So B is the issue here. So I'm going to keep that in mind, but I want to go to the other things just to make sure I'm on the right track. So that should be a flag. So it says, they saw students who were never on campus were more likely to drop out during their second year. Well, we have another plural pronoun here, but who is there talking about in this sentence? There is talking about students, plural. So the there in this situation is okay. And then we have more likely, more has to go with a than, so than is good. And a lot of people intermingle then and than, don't do it. Then indicates time, than indicates a comparison. And if we have a more, we need a than because we have a comparison. So D is fine, C is fine. The problem is B with they. So watch yourself. You will see complex sentences like this. And if you don't know that they is a plural pronoun and it doesn't go with a collective noun like university, you're going to be in trouble. Now, this is a very tricky thing that they do to people. Take a look at this sentence. Everyone should go to their locker before lunch. Okay. Now we have everyone should go to their locker. We have the word there, so we want to slow down and take a look at our subject. In this case, everyone is our subject or the noun of the sentence. Okay. Now when we hear everyone, we think everyone came to the party. Everyone was there. You're thinking all the people in the room. But everyone is actually a singular pronoun. It has the word one in it. Everyone should go to their locker? No, that doesn't match. And when you are on the test, they typically will not have you change the there, because if you were going to change there, it would have to be everyone should go to his or her locker or his locker, or everyone should go to her locker, to be politically correct, because there are plenty of people who are not a his or a him. We would use him or her, but better yet, or his or her, better yet, you should change the subject to a plural subject. So you'll most likely have an opportunity, like this might have an underline with it, to change everyone and make that the issue. So this should be changed to students. students should go to their lockers because there's more than one students. Be careful. This is what we call noun-noun agreement. There are multiple students, therefore there are multiple lockers. Not all the students in the school are going to one locker, so we would need to change the S there. So be on the lookout for everyone. They use that pronoun a lot with this pronoun there, and it does not agree. It's not pronoun antecedent agreement, okay?